Now, one interesting and important question comes in the mind of candidate. When to start the preparation for interview? This is a very important question. What is the right time to start preparation for interview?
First of all, a candidate must on himself decide when to start the preparation. The one way is you start right after the mains, but that I will not suggest is the ideal way, because you need yourself time after the mains, because you are basically drained physically as well as emotionally. So take your time and start, but don't give up on the current affairs part, because it's not that they will ask you current affairs, but it provides you a lot of confidence, which was earlier I was mentioning earlier as well. So, and it will keep you on track, and that's the basic purpose of this preparation early before the mains result. And right after the mains result, you have to identify the areas on which you have to focus. For example, you have to be very thorough with your DF. I would like to point out a few examples from my my interview. My interview was totally on the DF. It started with the Kumbh Mela, which is organized in Ujjain, and I was able to handle it in a very nice manner. And from that onward, my interview was totally on the DF base, and they did not ask me any cross questions, because I was able to answer the first part of the question in a very confident manner. So from that point onward, your interview goes very smoothly. So right after mains, you can focus on your DAF, and before the results of the mains, you should focus on developing your hobbies. For example, first of all, your hobbies must be very natural. You do not think that this hobby is not really like a administrator must have. So, but that's not really important. Important is your hobby should be natural, and you should develop it in the 2-3 months.
Ideally, the current affairs part should go on, but we prepare for mains exam, that thing gets covered naturally. But right after the mains exam, I think the candidate should align himself for the preparation of the interview. Because when the results come, the first interview starts only after 10 days.
Right.
So if the candidate waits for the results of the main exam, it might be too late if he happens to fall in the first few days. So ideally, full-fledged preparations should definitely start after the mains examination, with more focus on, like, one can increase the number of newspapers that one reads, and definitely DF has to be thorough, because maximum number of questions will be asked from DF only, and if you are able to handle it pretty well, then your interview will go smooth, because they expect that you are, DF is what something you have filled up, and right. You must be aware what you have filled up. And you should be ready to prepare, answer all those questions. One can't be sure of current affairs. They may ask anything under the sun, but at least one can be sure of DAF.
So apart from what Harshal and Rahul have said, I would like to reiterate that the factual part of it or the current affair, that is taken care of during the preparation of mains. But just after main examination, maybe a candidate should take a break of maybe a week or two. But after that, he should concentrate on the detailed application form that he has filled, and also on the background of his sub-graduation and optional. That part has to be there, because as he rightly pointed out, after the results are out, the time is very less. And one more thing is, he should, because in the interview, the non-verbal communication part is also checked.
Right.
Till mains, there is no test of non-verbal communication part. So one should start doing group discussions. One should try to interact with as many friends, as many person as you can, with many teachers, with anyone you can talk, because in the interview you will realize it's not very difficult questions or very tricky questions that are asked. So if you start interacting with, if you change the method of study, suppose listening to more news channels, news debates, the debates on Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha channels are very good, they cover, prepare it very well on various important issues, and one should try to interact with as many people as one can.
Right.
Then it polishes his personality and makes him enhances his ability to come across to his points, so that he can express in a very nice manner.
Sir, what I believe is that if you are going to prepare for civil services examination, so interview is also the part of preliminary as well as mains examination, because you have to gather or collect.
You mean to say there should be integrated preparation?
Yeah, integrated. And you must remember that. We must have a clarity of thoughts. So clarity of thought requires in preliminary exam as well as in mains exam. So no doubt, of course, it is required in interview test or personality test. So you need a lot of clarity about the subject, and the clarity of the subject simply gives you the confidence.
Right.
And confidence leads to you a very good rank or.
Sir, as far as the knowledge portion of the interview preparation goes, it should be in a continuum, and the way of preparation is we have now mobile cameras, video cams, and all. So when you are doing a friendly discussion, a mock interviews with friends will also help a lot.
You're right.
Because
right.
friends will be more frank in their opinion than a mock interview panel board and coaching classes will be. So more mock interviews you can give to your friends, and that too on a video camera so that you can watch it for yourself. So these two things are affordable and feasible.
I think all my friends have covered up the major points. I'll just sum it up because what they've said is the ideal way to prepare for the exams. So ideally one should take like a week or two, as my friend Suhas pointed out. One should not like stop reading newspapers or be aware of the current affairs. And you can go on to doing these things for 2 months, and probably like a month before the interviews begin, one can like brush up his optional as well as his degree subjects. And one should not, like as my friend pointed out, run from one coaching center to the other, because that puts unnecessary pressure on the candidate.
Sir, I would like to add is like, since this interview preparation checks your personality, so personality obviously cannot develop in a certain period of time. So since you are preparing a full-fledged course for this UPSC, a few informal ways of preparation which I used to take care of during my preparation was like when I was used to discuss some questions with my friends, I used to discuss in a manner that the way I would respond to somebody in a formal manner to somebody, like if that question was particularly asked to me in the interview, how would I respond to that? So the way you deal with your daily preparation and the way how you speak to others, if you keep in mind that this is the way, this is the format you might speak to, will generally help. After that, there comes the formal preparation, which I would certainly comply with all what my friends say.
सर जैसा कि केवल इंटरव्यू के समय केवल टाई और सूट बेल्ट लगा देने से ये जो है ना धारणा कि इंटरव्यू टाई हो जाए तो वो संभव नहीं है सर. मैं बैसनीर जी और सुहर्ष के बात तो पूर्णतः सहमत हूँ, क्योंकि मैंने इसी दोनों पॉइंट को अपने ग्रुप में अपनाया था, जिसमें मेरे ग्रुप में 50 रैंक, 52 रैंक और मैं 285 रैंक, तो सभी सिलेक्ट हो गए उस साल. दरअसल क्या है, इंटरव्यू बेसिकली ओपिनियन बेस्ड होता है, आपके विचार को वहाँ पर रखा जाता है, और विचार केवल आप एक दिन में नहीं बना सकते हैं कि रिजल्ट आया 10 दिन में कुछ पढ़ लिया विचार बन गए मेरे, तो इसके लिए आपको एक लंबा डिस्कशन करना पड़ता है. आप जो जिसमें तैयारी शुरू करते उसी समय से आपको जो है एक मोटा मोटी आपको विचार बनने शुरू हो जाते हैं कि मेरा क्या सोचना है लोकतंत्र के बारे में. क्या ये भी कभी कई बार पूछे चले जाते हैं लोकतंत्र आपकी क्या राय है, तो उसमें वो, और जो बेसिकली जो लास्ट टाइम ये होता है कि आप केवल चर्चा जितने अच्छे अपने जो दोस्त के साथ करेंगे, क्योंकि दोस्त जो हैं आपके जो कमियां हैं वो काफ़ी अच्छे तरीके से आपको बता सकते हैं.
सही बात है.
तो केवल होता क्या, हिंदी मीडियम छात्रों की सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम क्या है, वो इन्फॉर्मेशन गैदरिंग के चक्कर में रह जाते हैं, कई प्रकार सूचना क्या इकट्ठा करें, जबकि होना यह चाहिए कि किस प्रकार जो है केवल जो कुछ मेरे पास है पहले से उसको कितने अच्छे तरीके से हम प्रस्तुत कर पाए उनके समक्ष. इसके लिए जैसे अक्सर सिंह ने बताया है, अपने दोस्तों के साथ क्या करना है, उसको सामूहिक परिचर्चा करनी है, और कुछ न्यूज चैनल एक दो आप सुनिए, उसको अपना उसके आधार पर अपने विचार को बना लीजिए.
सो बेसिकली व्हाट कम्स फ्रॉम द डिस्कशन इज कि व्हेन टू स्टार्ट द प्रिपरेशन एंड हाउ टू स्टार्ट द प्रिपरेशन. दिस एग्जामिनेशन नेचर इज सच दैट इट्स बेटर टू कीप फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग इटसेल्फ. व्हेन द प्रिपरेशन बिगिंस दैट प्री मेंस इंटरव्यू दे हैव नॉट टू बी टेकन सेपरेटली, but the eye should be that finally I have to reach to the interview, finally I have to reach to the personality test. So whatever information is being gathered, whatever knowledge is gathered, there should be relevant, a good alertness, and at the same time presentation skill
and development of opinion should be taken care from the beginning itself.
So that it doesn't come that, as you nicely said, that the personality cannot be changed overnight. The good thing can happen that if it is consciously students, candidates are trying from the beginning that I have to finally reach the interview level. So I have to prepare in a way that it is not only that I have to adopt a strategy of pre or just for the mains, but I should make a holistic plan.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.